So germs and viruses been out there for a very long time. It's not something new, guys, but today's world, we've been dealing with a pandemic virus. Unfortunately, due to the circumstances, we understand the importance of washing and cleaning our hands. But in fact, what is the biggest transmitter of viruses in your house? Your door locks. Yes, I'm talking about door locks in every door in your house. In today's video, I will demonstrate and show you guys what happens when you're touching a dirty lock and where you leave all the germs and all the objects that you touch right after using this product, the Glow Germ, and also using a UV black light. We will track down all the objects and surfaces that you touch, even if your hands was clean right before you enter the door. Make sure to stick till the end of the video, guys. I will share with you my best tips how you can make sure that you don't spread viruses any further in the house and what you should do to make sure that your locks are clean and sanitized the right way. Stay tuned. Okay guys, really quick, before we're gonna start, I just want to introduce myself. If you're new to my channel, my name is Kobe. I'm with Silver Eagle Locksmith Las Vegas YouTube channel. If you're interested in home security related stuff, learn how to do it yourself the right way, save time and money, consider subscribing and make sure to click the bell notification and turn on all notifications, because if you don't, YouTube won't let you know when I release new videos, when I release them. Okay, without further ado, let's move on to the actual demonstration. I will show you guys right now how dirty your door locks really is and what you need to do to protect yourself and your loved ones. Coming up right now. Okay, so the first, what we're gonna do is putting the powder, the Glow Germ powder, on the locks. We're gonna spread that powder on them. And as you can see, my hands right now don't have any germs. It's clean, so it's not shiny on the UV black light, also the locks. And let's start by spreading the powder. A bit of that. So basically the powder is acting like, suppose the germs, they're gonna be invisible to the eye, as they really are. And when we're gonna touch it, the door lock, then we're gonna see what happened right after. Okay. Okay, as you can see now, oh, it glows. Those are your germs. And you see my hand? No problem. Okay, moving on. What happened now when you enter the house? If your door locks are dirty, you're touching your door, and look at that. Supposedly, you're touching the door locks with your hand. All right, move on, see what happened next by spreading the germs and other objects in your house. Okay, now I'm basically in my kitchen, as you can see, touching the other hand and then touching my laptop, playing with the mouse, basically just do normal things that you do when you're coming back to the house. All right, then trying to open my TV, just touching the remote. Basically doing something that everybody's doing when they're coming back to the house. Oh, I really opened the TV. Okay, let's move on. Touching the microwave. Very basic. Wanna open it? Close it. Use the microwave. Open the refrigerator. Other side of the refrigerator. And finally, the last thing and the most important thing that you shouldn't do: touch your face. Let's see what happened right now
after I touch my face. Okay, let's move on and see with the black light what happened with objects that I touch right after I touch the door lock. Let's move on. Okay, so now we're gonna use the black light and see the track of the germs that I spread in the house after touching the door lock. Okay, the first thing, let's see the remote from close up. Look at that. As you can see, there's marks, my fingerprint marks. That's basically the germs right there. Move on to the keyboard of my computer. Look at this. It's all over the place. Check it out. A mouse. Look how dirty it becomes. Look at this. All right, so. Okay, now let's see what happened with the microwave that we touched. So you can see clearly, there is all the germs, the numbers on the handle. It's clearly right there. Let's also see what happened with the refrigerator. Look at that. We spread the germs from the door locks everywhere in the kitchen now. And whoever touch the refrigerator can basically get the virus. The first thing that you need to know is not touching your face. Look what happened after you're touching the door lock, and it's all over your face just by touching it. So avoid touching your face at all costs. So now you know what you shouldn't do. Don't spread the virus any further by touching your door locks and not sanitize them the right way. Let's move on and I will show you from close up what you need to do to clean them the right way, coming up right now. What I like to do to clean and sanitize the door locks is using minimum 70% alcohol. Yes, 70% and up will definitely kill the virus. And if you can see right now, the germs still in the door lock, and now we're gonna clean them the right way and check what happened right after. All right, I'm gonna use a regular paper towel, just clean the area as much as you can. Now, alcohol will definitely have less damage to the actual locks, to the finish. So it's much more safe than using a bleach, for example. Okay, let's see what's going on. You see, it's much more clean now. Of course, you can still see it in some areas that I can't reach with the paper towel, but yeah, it definitely sanitized the door locks, and that's the proper way to clean your door locks and sanitize them. Now you know how to clean and sanitize your door locks and any hard surface in your house the right way. That way you will keep you and your loved ones saved from any germs and viruses. And I hope that you did like this video. If you have any questions about what we did today, or if you have any questions in general, just write a comment in the comment section below, and I promise that I will answer as soon as I can. And also don't forget, if you didn't do so, like my videos. Yes, give a like to my video. I appreciate it. Thank you. This is how YouTube rewards me. Okay, so don't forget, like the video. And if you're new to my channel, also consider subscribing and make sure to click the bell notification and turn on all notifications so you will be notified when I release new videos, when I release them. I also share links of my previous videos that I did. I'm pretty sure that you will find them super interesting as well. Make sure to check those videos right now, and I will see you in my next video. Thank you so much.